Something else looking really good. Molly's Game is getting award season buzz, and our next guest took part in the actual high-stakes poker games alongside the real Molly Bloom. Welcome, Madison Mckinley. Wow.
Good morning.
Good to see you.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, so you actually play yourself in the movie, and I want to get to that in a second, but how did you and Molly first meet?
Actually, I went to the same school as Molly Bloom.
High school?
The same high school. Okay. I didn't know her growing up, but I was good friends with her brothers, Jeremy and Jordan Bloom. Mm-hmm. Jeremy's a skier. And then afterward, when Molly moved to New York, her brothers introduced me, thinking that it would be a good match.
And you ended up working with her in these high-stakes poker rooms. What was that like?
Wow. At times it was intense, at times it was long, at times it was mind-blowing, but quite a ride.
I'm sure. So the movie comes along. When you first heard that there was going to be a movie about this, what was your reaction?
A lot of people throw out the idea of, you know, something being a dream come true or being super surreal, but for me, this is so literally that. I remember sitting with Molly and just talking about how we would ever get out of this, and she's like, oh, I would love for there to be a movie about it.
Really?
But nothing interesting had really happened at that point, so for everything to kind of come to fruition,
right,
it's amazing.
And you, how was it when you guys were actually watching the movie and seeing it all in, like, unfold in front of you?
I had the opportunity to watch it once with Molly, mm-hmm. and I mean, we were just laughing, and everything for the movie for us is an inside joke, and just, you know, this and this and
right.
this, and yeah. you know who each player is, and it was such a dream come true.
How many years was this going on, and when?
Mm-hmm. She worked in New York for a couple years, I think 2 to 3 years, uh-huh. and I worked with her during that time, and then yeah. before that, she was in L.A. running games also.
And I always heard celebrities would go to these. Oh, yeah. poker games, right?
We had a list of clientele, yeah, that's yeah. for sure.
But people there's that one you would... actor in particular that is sort of focused on throughout all of it.
Yes.
Who is that actor in real
life? I don't know if I'm allowed to say who that actor is. That is Player X.
Player X.
Did you guys do,
I hear he's quite the gambler.
Did you guys do just the private games, or did you get involved like with the World Series of Poker and the big games in Vegas?
We would take players from all of the above, but yeah. for us it was just a private.
Okay.
Huh. So she actually was Molly Bloom's right hand, and then the movie comes out and she has to actually audition to play herself. Did you have to audition in front of Aaron Sorkin, and what was that like?
I did. Molly was a great friend, and she's like, I promise I can get you in the room. I can't do anything other than that.
Right. Mm-hmm.
After that, it's up to you. So I sat down in front of Francine and in front of Aaron and said the lines, and thank goodness.
It worked out.
It worked out, yeah.
Fabulous. Okay, let's take a look at a clip from Molly's Game.
You ran games in L.A. for roughly 8 years?
Yeah.
And then you ran games in New York for roughly 2.
I haven't run a game in over 2 years, not to spoil the ending. But that's when the government raided my game and took all of my money, assuming all of it was made illegally, which it wasn't. In this room, you couldn't buy your win.
I'm all in.
You couldn't buy me, and you couldn't buy a seat at the table.
Movie stars, athletes, billionaires, that's just the tip of the iceberg.
You're not taking a percentage of the pot?
No.
Keep it that way, because you don't want to break the law when you're breaking the law.
Am I breaking the law?
Not really.
There you go.
That's our question.
Okay. That's our question, Jessica.
I said maybe this is a silly question, but they bring it up in the movie. Was it against the law at any point in time to have these, you know, these people coming together to gamble?
And it is said in the movie, it is a really gray area and a very fine line. The only thing that makes it illegal is when you start taking a rake like they would in a casino or
what
somewhere
else. What is a rake?
A rake is when you take a percentage of the pot that's out, so you can take to cover the cost of it in case somebody can't pay at the end. You start taking pot, you know, like 2%. It changes depending on how big the pot is, but that's what makes it illegal.
So when
otherwise,
you,
it's a friendly game of poker.
Got it. Yeah. Okay. So when you were actually on set, you kind of served as a little bit of a like a advisor on set, right? Because you'd actually been in the room.
It was interesting for me to watch. They had a bunch of people. They had professional players. I was there just to make sure that it was authentic. Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't think that I offered anything that anyone else couldn't have done, but they really made it so accurate to how it was during the nights and during the games that I was amazed. It was unbelievable.
Do you play poker?
Just for fun.
Poker. Does that make you kind of want to stay away from it?
Yes, it does.
Really?
Yes.
Interesting.
Could you be a good poker player, though, if we had to sit down and play a game?
I mean, we can do it after this.
Yeah. Wow. I take a rake, though. I'll walk that gray area.
I like that we're throwing around the lingo.
Yeah, I know.
We sound really cool.
And probably not using it correctly.
Of course not. Of course not.
Do you know, have you ever gone down the river?
Have I rivered?
Yeah, have you
Yes.
Have you rivered, not
See, not gone down. No, perfect example of using the lingo wrong.
Yeah.
Just like you said. Perfect example. Thank you so much
for having me.
Madison Mckinley. Molly's Game hits theaters on Friday.
Thanks, Madison.
Thank you.
Coming up here at 14 years old, he's already getting lots of attention in Hollywood.
Thomas Barbusca is here to tell us all about his work on The Mick.